He was arguably the best rebounder in the game, worth $23 million. Now, he's worth $500,000. Dennis Rodman's story is one of success, scandal, partying, and generosity. He's a walking contradiction. He breaks all the rules while simultaneously being a team player. So, where did all his money go? After all, his teammate Michael Jordan handled his money just fine and now sits at $2.1 billion. So what happened to Dennis's? Today, we're looking at one of the most fascinating and talented players to ever pick up a basketball, as we look at what happened to Dennis Rodman's wealth. Dennis Keith Rodman was born May 13, 1961, in Trenton, New Jersey, to Philander and Shirley Rodman. When he was only 3 years old, his father deserted the family, leaving his mother to raise him and his two siblings. Dennis's childhood demons didn't stop there, as he grew up poor, was painfully shy, and he was bullied by the other kids in his neighborhood. After graduating high school, he got a job as a janitor. Looking back on these tough years, Dennis has expressed how bleak his future looked. He said, "I thought I would be in jail. I thought I'd be a drug dealer or be dead. Those were my options." But throughout all the hardship, Dennis kept up with his basketball game, and in 1 year, grew almost a full foot. The scrawny 5'11 high schooler was now 6'8", and he could play. Rodman won a basketball scholarship to Southeastern Oklahoma State University in 1983, and by 1985, he led the National Association of Intercollegiate Athletics in rebounding. He had the talent, and the NBA took notice. In 1986, he was the second round draft pick of the Detroit Pistons, where he played forward, and he and his crew on the court would come to be known as the Bad Boys. And during his tenure, he made an estimated $5 million. Rodman was traded to the Spurs for 3 years, racking in another $4.9 million in wages. But he found his true home and calling with the legendary Chicago Bulls in 1985, a team that also housed Scottie Pippen and Michael Jordan. And it was here that the money really started coming in. Rodman's earnings peaked at $9 million a year, with a total of $16.1 million total earned for his time in the Windy City. And though his teammates didn't always appreciate his on and off the court antics, Rodman did what he did best and acted as arguably the best rebounder the game has ever seen. With his help, the Bulls won the 96, 97, and 98 NBA championship titles. Dennis Rodman was on top of the world, which makes this next statistic all the more tragic. When it was all said and done, Dennis had made $27.5 million from the NBA, but today, he's worth $500,000. And it is all the more head-scratching when you think about the fact that his buddy Scottie Pippen is currently worth a whopping $30 to $50 million, and the leader of his group, Michael Jordan, is worth a colossal $2.1 billion. So, just where did all Rodman's money go? Well, let's be clear about one thing right off the bat. Rodman is eccentric. He does what he wants, when he wants, how he wants, and with who he wants. He was known for buying expensive houses, expensive cars, throwing lavish parties, and having to pay an exorbitant amount of fines. As far as homes go, Rodman has owned a duplex in Newport Beach worth an estimated $500,000. That doesn't sound that lavish to you? Well, what if we told you that Rodman lived in the top unit and converted the bottom unit into a nightclub known as Club 4809? To quote Rodman, "When you showed up at Club 4809, better count on an all-night party." This club had a bar, dance floor, and of course, a disco ball. And the parties? They were loud. Dennis claims that the police were called on him at least 80 times. But that wasn't his only residence. He also owned a home on an acre of land in Saddle Hill Ranch, complete with a double door entry, vaulted ceilings, billiards room, and gourmet kitchen with granite island. In the master suite, there's a steam shower and sauna, and outside you'll find a pool, storage barn, and a horse corral. When he sold it in the late 1990s, it went for $1.1 million. But Rodman didn't only splurge on homes. He loved cars and had plenty of them. Arguably, his most recognizable ride was his Lamborghini Gallardo, a $165,900 supercar. And that doesn't include the custom paint job, which included gold paint flakes and a side portrait of Rodman himself that had a trail of flames. This was truly Dennis's car. He also owned a 96 Porsche 993 TT, worth $105,500. It harbored substantial customizations and also touted a custom paint job, just nowhere near as eccentric as his Lambo. Rodman was a huge fan of his $800,000 Hummer H1 as well, complete with a Panasonic head unit and aftermarket speakers. This baby also housed a CTIS tire inflation system, which allowed Rodman to control the air pressure of the individual tires. An incredible convenience if you find yourself switching from highway driving to off-road. But all these lavish cars and homes aren't enough to lose almost $26 million. Which brings us to the outrageous amount of fines that Mr. Rodman had to pay over the course of his time in the NBA and after. Rodman was once fined $200,000 for kicking a referee in the groin and went on to lose an estimated $1 million in salary for a suspension that lasted 11 games. Then, just before Game 4 in the 1998 Finals versus the Utah Jazz, he disappeared, only to be seen on TV wrestling with Hulk Hogan. And he had to pay $20,000 in fines. But it doesn't stop there. In 1996, he headbutted a ref and was fined $20,000 and suspended for 6 games. And who could forget his $68,000 fine in 1992 for skipping preseason camp? And we haven't even gotten to his off-the-court fines and expenses. Rodman has been married 3 times, and if you think that divorce court is cheap, well, it isn't. And in 2012, his lawyer said he was unable to pay the $800,000 worth of child and spousal support that he owed. Then there was his trouble with the law. Rodman has been arrested multiple times, including one drunk driving arrest where he was fined $2,000. But what about his parties? Rodman is legendary for partying hard and all night. His 40th birthday party was one for the books, as he had over 200 guests, arrived on the beach by helicopter, and had 2 live rock bands in his backyard. As you can imagine, the neighbors called the police. Apparently, rock bands and helicopters can get pretty loud. The total noise complaint violations came to $8,500, and due to Rodman's criminal misdemeanors, he was looking at $3,000 in fines. And if you add that to his probation violation, he was looking at jail time and $2,000 more in fines. Now, here's the thing. We know it's easy to look at Dennis and hear about his troubles at home and write him off as some attention-seeking superstar who splurged all his money on himself without ever thinking about anyone else. But you would be wrong, my friend. Dennis Rodman is an incredibly generous individual and has been known to be quite gracious to his fans and those that have supported him over the years. Remember that 11-game suspension we talked about? Well, check out this statement released by Rodman soon afterwards. In light of my recent suspension, I have decided to donate my regular game salary for the next 11 games to charity. This is in addition to the 11-game fine I have already received. I am doing this as a gesture of appreciation to all the fans that have supported me throughout my career. Rodman donated to the James Jordan Boys and Girls Foundation, March of Dimes, Magic Johnson AIDS Foundation, and many more, totaling $576,892. And he has been known to give away the money in his pocket to those who need it. One time, he gave a homeless woman and her 2 children all the money in his pocket, which came to $250. Not such a bad guy after all, huh? If there's one thing we know for sure, Dennis Rodman will continue to fascinate fans of basketball for years to come. Could he have been wiser with his money? Sure. But that wouldn't be Rodman. He's always done it his way and always lived his life the way he wanted, even if it means he's no longer one of the richest.